I'm a very good fellow. I'm a good person. I'm very, very religious. And by that, I mean I hate women. That's not true, but you guys know what I'm talking about, right? The church hates women, all right? The church hates women and gay people, all right? If you think about it, the 11th commandment is, thou shalt not catch a dick. That's like a big rule of the church, right? I don't understand why I hate those two groups of people. I really like those two groups of people. They're good people. And that always makes me feel bad. Because I consider myself like a good Christian, you know? Like, me and Jesus, we've got a lot in common. We're just two black guys with weird dads. Every time I think about the crucifixion of Jesus, I feel really bad for Joseph. Joseph is like the world's most famous cuck, if you think about it. Joseph's claim to fame is that he was not the father. That's the big takeaway from the Bible if you're team Joseph, all right? And you have to realize, every time Jesus did something incredible, people were going up to Joseph and talking to him about it, you know? Just like, hey, is it true your son turned water into wine? Only for Joseph to be like, oh, that's actually my wife's kid. And then he'd point to Mary, and the other people would be like, you mean that 14-year-old girl? Like, yeah, I couldn't lock that down, apparently. Why is Mary so young? 14 years old, that's crazy young. That's super creepy. What is guy of the same taste in women as R. Kelly? That's the grossest. Are you guys Christian or R. Kelly fans? I can't tell the difference at this point. Although, if you told me that God and R. Kelly were the same person, I might believe you, all right? On the eighth day, he made the remix to Ignition. That song is powerful, okay? That's a really good song, all right? I'm a decent person. Partially because I was brainwashed by the church, but partially because I was hit by my mom growing up. White people hate this joke, right? Yeah, I guess, growing up, my mother would hit me, or if you're British, I was raised by the hand. That's how I was raised, okay? White people hate it when I talk about, my mom hitting me. They're like, oh my God, I could never hit a child. That's the same race as me. No, that's over the line, no, right? White people do everything else besides hit a child. White people will arrest children before they hit children, all right? White people will put children in cages before they hit children. White people will even let children have children before hitting children, all right? That's a fucked up sense of morality, right? Whenever I tell this joke, white people will come up to me after me. White people will come up to me after this bit, and they'll say, oh my gosh. So growing up, your mom spanked you? And I'll go, no, okay, that's very weird, okay? I don't want to kink shame your parents, but what the fuck is that, all right? That's a creepy thing to do. No, my mother didn't spank me. That's gross as fuck. You hit a child, you spank a woman. There's a difference, okay? All right, fucking A. That joke usually does pretty well. I'm sorry. Okay. This is a very tame... Either this is a very sexually tame crowd, or you were all also hit like me. I was raised by my mom. My entire life, my mom raised me and my sister by herself. My mom had two jobs and two kids all by herself. Round of applause for my mom, you guys, all right? Woo! It's weird that you guys applauded there after I talked to you about my mom hitting me, but anyway. My entire life, my mom had two jobs and two kids, and growing up, she'd give me this great piece of advice. She'd always say, figure it out, which is great advice for a kid, you know? That teaches you how to be, strong and intuitive and, that teaches you how to be a good person. But as an adult, that teaches you how to be, an asshole, because there are problems you can't figure out, right? Like my best friend, he's a heroin addict, and intellectually, I know that's not a problem you can figure out, but emotionally... I'm like, hey, have you tried not being addicted to heroin? You just try it? If you told my mom you were addicted to heroin, she'd say, this is what you do. If somebody offers you heroin, you say no thank you. You go home, you make rice, you put it in the fridge. That's what you do, right? And if you said that's not a reasonable answer, she'd say, it's not my fault you don't have rice, okay? That's on you. Because my mom had so many jobs growing up, like the big thing in our house was her sleep. Like if my mom, like every time I saw my mom, she said, if I'm asleep, never wake me up, like hospice. That was her. So when I was a kid, my mom was asleep and I had like a problem, I have to solve it myself because I was afraid of waking my mom up. Which is to say, I'd solve problems terribly, okay? Like my friends would come up to me bleeding and say, hey, I think we have to wake up your mom. And I'd say, well, I think you're more comfortable with you dying than me waking up my mom, all right? That's not gonna happen. I think it's better if we part ways right now, Tyler. if you ask like a 9-year-old me, like, hey Aaron, why doesn't the boogeyman eat you every night? I'd say, well, I think it's because he doesn't want to wake my mom up. As a kid, whenever I went to bed, I never woke my mom up. Instead, I would take off my pants and I'd fall asleep on the floor like a very messy Winnie the Pooh. And whenever this happened, my mom would find me in the morning and she'd go, what happened? And I'd have to lie to her and I'd go, oh, you'll never believe it. This guy, he broke into the house and he peed on my bed. And he woke me up and I said, hey, pee guy, you gotta get out of here. Because I'm the man of the house. And the pee guy, he looks at me and he goes, wow, little black boy, because he's white. He goes, wow, little black boy, you're so brave. When your mom wakes up, she should make you pancakes. My mom, she'd go, Autumn, you're not getting pancakes. There's rice in the fridge, all right? That's, all right. I'm Aaron Wildersleser. Thank you so much. Woo!